for sure. Look who's here, Sophia Bush from the very own family, CW. She's one of ours. Yes. We're one of hers.
She's family.
However you want to look at it, from One Tree Hill, your character, Brooke Davis. You guys are back. 2-hour premiere tonight.
Yeah, we start at 8 o'clock tonight.
How are you?
I'm really excited. I'm good. How are you guys?
Good. Isn't she just adorable?
She really is. Happy
I love her new haircut, too.
It's gone.
Yeah, she chopped it.
I did. I actually got home for the holidays and saw my mom, and she was like, you have no hair.
Now, this isn't going to cause any sort of, you know...
You're right. Stressful situations when you cut your hair.
Yes. You know, we've been getting shorter and shorter all season. I've sort of had leeway with this 4-year jump.
That's kind of a cool thing what's happening, right? Yeah. Tell everybody.
We've jumped ahead 4 years. We ended season 4 graduating from high school, and now we're all coming back after the 4 years where people have been in college or working.
You just skip that part.
Yeah.
Just jump right ahead.
And we're sort of doing these really cool flashback things, sort of like Lost used to do, where you'll jump into somebody's life and what they've been doing and sort of see how everything has come about.
And that's very cool, and the hair works, because I was just thinking all this time we were talking about the hair was, remember when Felicity cut her hair? It was almost the end of the whole show.
It was a big deal. So we were never allowed to cut our hair, but because of the jump, I cut mine, and my character, Brooke, is... this sort of fashion mogul. So I've changed my hair color 3 times this season. It keeps getting shorter, and it's sort of the thing that they're really enjoying, and it's great for me because for 4 years I wasn't allowed to.
Right now you can, because now you're grown up.
When you flash back to college, did anybody do anything wild and fun?
Yeah, what happened?
Are there good, you know, college flashbacks?
It's pretty interesting. You know, you see what everybody's been up to, me working in New York and Peyton working for a record label in L.A., Lucas getting his novel published, what's sort of happening in being grown-ups who are married with Nathan and Haley, and that's particularly
emotional.
Look at you! Yeah, doing a little red carpet action in New York, which actually was shot on Stage 7 in Wilmington. But we built the whole thing, and InStyle was nice enough to let us put their name
there. So who comes back with major issues? Anybody fall off the wagon or anything kind
Everybody
of dramatic
has some pretty good drama, but it's funny because Brooke was always a really lovable mess in high school, and now she's the one everyone's coming to for advice, and she's sort of sitting here going, I still have problems.
Right.
But everybody is in really interesting sort of intersecting points.
How did they let you know at the end of the season what was going to happen when you came back? Did they just sort of say, here, enjoy? Or did you have an inkling of where they were trying to go with the new season?
Well, our writers were pitching the idea last year because they had to get approval from the network. And I think the network freaked out a little bit. But once they saw the outlines and the ideas that Mark Schwann and our whole writing team had put together, they got really excited. And it's been really incredible for us because it reinvigorates the story and it reinvigorates the show.
Sure does.
Well, we want to do a little flashback of our own. Look back when you guys were just baby-faced freshmen.
Oh, no.
Do we have that clip?
Oh, no. Is it coming? Maybe it's not, which would be great.
You know, they're racking.
I think...
There it is.
Oh, please, you look fantastic.
Oh, well.
How many years has it been now?
This is our 5th season. It's just so odd to look back at it, though.
You haven't changed. Your hair's different, but you look just as good.
You know, I think this is a brilliant concept, though, of having you guys skip those 4 years and then having flashbacks. You can actually write 2 scenarios or 2 shows.
Yeah,
because all of a sudden you can write the present day and you can write the college years all in the same time. I think it's brilliant. If this one's not working for me, well, I'll put her back in college.
Exactly.
You know?
It's been very, very cool. And I think also for us, we know because we've watched enough of the teen shows. You know, I grew up, high school was Dawson's Creek and Felicity for me. The college years, when you go from high school into that, it's been done so many times. We don't want to do, you know, what 90210 did. My best friend's going to kill me because she watches every episode that re-airs every night. But, you know, we wanted to give a new spin to the show. And I think it's a lot of fun because in the beginning, you don't quite know why everything's happening.
Yeah.
It's a little bit of mystery for us, and it's a mystery that the viewers get to sort of puzzle together with us as the episodes keep going.
Well, we want to take a little sneak peek at the new season, which debuts tonight. Let's check it out.
That is not the face of a happy girl who got everything she wished for.
A lot of things, but not everything.
Well, are you counting the trip to Milan?
The trip for work.
Come on. Let's see the face of a girl who gets to go to Italy tomorrow to approve the textiles for her fall line.
But it's not everything.
No, dear. It is everything. And if you've lost sight of that, you have lost your way, Brooke Davis. Milan, tomorrow. Smile.
Smile. We have a couple new faces, right? We've got Daphne Zuniga, K-Fed, making an appearance.
Really?
Yeah. Yes.
The two of them came in. He comes in briefly, and we've got a whole incredible crew of new guest stars: Michaela McManus and Joe Manganiello and Robbie Jones, and just amazing people who really add a lot to
exciting
the show.
Stuff. Well, a completely new season of One Tree Hill kicks off with the 2-hour premiere and a special time, 8 o'clock tonight. Then it moves to its regular time of 9 o'clock on Tuesdays after the encore episodes of Crowned. Sophia Bush, thank you so much for being here.
Really nice to see you guys.
So back in LA. Now that they're not taping in North Carolina. So she's back to see Mama and Daddy.
Yeah, my parents are thrilled, and I got to come home to my puppies this year. And it's really nice.
Good to be home.
Yeah, it's an odd thing to be able to call my girlfriends on a Tuesday night and say, hey, do you want to go to dinner? Because I'm in the same state as you.
It's been really lovely.
Tonight, do you sit down and watch? Do you call your girlfriends and go, hey, 2 hours, let's...
We were planning a dinner, and one of my best friends looked at me last night and goes, are you ridiculous? I know your show's premiering tomorrow. We're watching it.
Can't get away from it.
Yeah, they're very supportive, even when I sort of want to hide.
Well, good to have you back, Southern California.
Come visit us again.
It's nice to be here.
Okay. Take care, Sophia.